and the mysterious sword had to teleport into the other world too. It disappeared with me when I was in a mysterious place. But I had no idea where it could be. Anyway, I will have to find it before the creature from the mysterious cave does. I woke up the day after. I was so exhausted. I was just lying on the destroyed floor, and I barely walked. Everything was so hard and painful, I needed some potion of healing. And luckily I had one. In the chest. It tasted so good. I finally got some rest, and I could also think of my past, about my close ones. Starting with my dearest friend, Tirza. And her mum. Aunt was always so kind to everyone. I remember I always liked fishing. It was fun, at least for me. Tirza couldn't catch anything. She was quite bad in this, I was way more successful, but sometimes it was really hard, really. And I also remember when my mum was watching us, when we were fishing. Anyway, Tirza was really good in something else. We used to train her fighting skills. And not with an actual sword, of course. We used wooden sticks so we didn't hurt each other. And my father watched over us. He's a really good fighter. He's the one who taught us all those cool flips and techniques, and I tried my best, but she was way better than me. I didn't stand a chance against her. But at the end, we always ended up in peace. And when we had some free time, we've always wanted to go to the mountains on our favorite spot. It was quite high, so Tessa's father used to go with us. There was a really good view to the valley with my house in the middle of the lake, and we spent there a lot of time together. We were really close to each other, and I was glad for every second with her. I wish I can take these times back again. I really do. I really do. But now I had a much bigger problem here. The creature. The creature might be somewhere nearby. It could follow me anywhere and any time. It might be much closer than I ever thought.